Then what we do is we will have a light up program to find some of all the density given number. So if you are having a number, suppose consider 3, 4, 1 is a 1 number. So what we have to do is we have to find some of all the numbers. That is, we have to find 3 plus 4 plus 1. So which is equal to 8. So what is our input is, input our program is 341, output our program is 8. So for this one we have to write the program. So first of all what we have to do is, in the number given number 341, we have to extract the digits. We have to extract the digits. So here what is the, so here this is 0 place, 10 place, 100 place. So first we have to extract 1 from 341. How we can extract 1 from 341? Which operation we have to perform? So we have to perform modulus operation with which number?
10.
So we have to perform with the 10. So why do you know this? So first we have to verify. Suppose if I perform mod with 1, what is the value? If you perform 341 with mod with 1, what is the value? How many times 1 will divide 341? 341. So what is the value? What is the value? 0. Suppose if you perform, are we getting last digit or not? Are we getting last digit? No, we are not getting. So we have to perform 341 with mod 2. What is the value? We are getting mod 1. So we are getting result as 1. So we have to verify, suppose 34. 34 with mod 2. What is the value? 34 mod 2. Reminder. If you use reminder operator, it is reminder. But what is the actual required reminder? 4. So it is wrong. So we have to verify multiple things. So reminder with 3 and reminder with 4, so on, so that it has to be applicable for each and every number. So we have to perform operation with each and every number. So we have to get, it has to be applicable for each and every number. So if we verify all those things, we will get 341 with mod 10. What is the value now? 1. Similarly, if we perform 34 with mod 10, what is the value? 4. Similarly, if we perform 3 with mod 10, we get 3. So we are extracting individual digits, the first we are extracting 1, and then we are extracting 4, and then we are extracting 3. So that's why we have to perform with 10. So we have to verify why we are performing only 10, not with 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. So for that one, we have to do this operation. So this is the way how we have to extract. So initially, what is our number is 341. After first iteration, our number has to become 34. Okay, how to extract 34 from 341? So for that one, we have to perform division with 10. So here, what is the requirement is, why we have to perform division with 10? Not with 1 or 2 or 3. So for that one, we have to perform again same operation. First, we perform 341 by 1. What is the value? Its value is 340. Similarly, we perform 341 by 2. What is the value? Nearly 170. So we are not getting the value. So finally we can conclude that if we perform division with 10, definitely we get 34. Now again we will verify. So 34 with 10, what is the value? 34 with 10, what is the value? 3 by 10, what is our value? 3 by 10, what is the value? How many times it will divide? It will divide with 0 times. It will divide with 0 times. So that means we have to perform this operation up to we receive 0. So we have to repeat this operation up to our value is 0. So for that one we have to write the logic. So how many times we are repeating this operation here? How many times we are repeating this operation? We are performing 10 with, first we are performing reminder operator with 10, that is 341, reminder 10, what is the value? 341 reminder 10 is 1. Next we have to perform 34 reminder 10 which is equal to 4. 3 mod 10 which is equal to 3. So how many times we have performed this operation is 3 times. Suppose if we are having a big number something like 1221. How many times we have to perform this operation? 4 times. Suppose if we are having another some other big number, that is 1221, we have to perform this one for 5 times. So that means whenever we are performing, repeatedly performing the same operation for multiple times, we have to use a looping statement. So we know we are having different type of looping statements. Either we can go for loop or while loop. Depends upon our flexibility, we can go for any one of the loop. So first what we will do is write the logic. So already we told you we have to repeat our operation up to first one is 34. What is the value? 34. 34 divided by 10, what is the value? 3. 3 divided by 10, what is the value? 0. So we have to repeat our operation up to 0. So for that one, we have to write the looping statement, that is while. We have to perform this operation up to number greater than 0. So why we are performing? So we have to take this condition, that is we have to repeat our operation. Even if we perform 0 by 10, what is the value? 10 only. So sorry, 0 only. So there is no need to repeat this operation. So we have to perform our operation up to greater than 0. So that is why number greater than 0. So what are the operations we are performing here is, first operation we are performing is finding the remainder operator. Finding the remainder and second one is division operator and then sum. So for that one we have to take three variables. First variable is number and second variable is, to find the remainder we are using a variable called remainder, and next variable we are taking is sum, which we have to initialize with 0. So now first we have to find the number. So for that one we have to read the value of number. So we can read with the help of a scanner statement, printf and scanner statement, we can read that number. So first, what is the first operation we have to perform is, we have to find the remainder. How to find the remainder? By performing remainder operator, that is remainder is equal to number mod 10. After finding the remainder, we have to get the new number. How to get the new number is, we have to find number is equal to number by 10. Okay. And then what we have to do is, whatever the remainder we are getting, we have to add this number to the sum. So how to add is, we have to perform the operation sum is equal to sum plus remainder. So we have to perform these operations repeatedly until number is greater than 0. So what we do is, we will take one number and we will verify whether it is correct or not, whether our logic is correct or not. So this what we will do is, we will take the same number, that is 341. So what is our number is? Number is equal to 341. So we have to find remainder as well as sum. So initially number is 341. So 341 is greater than 0 or not? It is true. So if it is true, we have to execute remainder. How to find the remainder is, that is 341 mod 10. What is the value? 341 mod 10 is equal to 1. So what we have to do is, initially sum is equal to 0, that is 0 plus 1, which is equal to 1. Next. What is our new number? What is our new number? What is our new number is, with help of this operation we are performing 341 by 10, which is equal to 34. Now we will check the condition whether 34 is greater than 0 or not. It is true. If it is true, then what we have to do is, we have to perform 34 by 10. What is the value of 34 by 10 is? First we have to perform remainder operator, then we have to find the new number. So first remainder operator, we have to execute in the sequence. Okay, that is number and then sum. So first 341, then we have to perform 341 divided by 10, which is equal to 34. What is our sum is 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So next condition is 34 is greater than 0, it is true. Then what we have to do is, we have to find the remainder, that is 34 mod 10, which is equal to 4. And we have to find the new number, that is 34 divided by 10, which is equal to 3. So what we have to do is, we have to add 4 to the sum previous value. What is our previous sum is 1. 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. And then what is our new number is 3. We have to verify this condition, that is 3 greater than 0. So 3 greater than 0 is true. Then what we have to do is, we have to treat the same operation, that is first we have to perform 3 mod 10, which is equal to 3. And then 3 divided by 10, which is equal to 0. And we have to add this remainder to our sum. Previous sum, that is 5 plus 3, which is equal to 8. Next, what is our condition is we have to verify number that is 0 greater than 0 or not. So 0 greater than 0 is a false statement. So we cannot execute further. And finally, what we have to do is we have to perform. We have to display the value, we have to display the value of sum. So in this way we can find the sum of the individual digits. So next, what we do is, can we write the same program with the help of another looping statement? So just what we will see how to modify this program. We have written this program in while loop. Just we will see how to write the same program with the help of some other looping statement. So